Hey everyone, Hitesh here from ET's Personal Tech Team. And today we're taking a look at a very premium laptop from HP. It's part of the Spectre series, as you can see here. And this is the Spectre Folio. Now, it's called the Folio because of a couple of very important reasons, and we'll just get to that when we actually unbox this machine. Let me just keep this off to the side. This is the laptop itself, of course. I'll just keep this off to the side and see what else we get in the box. There, this is the charger. It's a USB Type-C that gives us a clue as to what ports this machine has. In here we have the basic documentation, just a quick start guide. That's about it. This tray lifts up, and inside here you've got the rest of a charger. It's a two-piece charger, so this is the Indian plug, of course, but they have given a compact version if you just want to attach the plug here to the charger, to the wall charger. Also included, this is a USB Type-C to USB-A, the full-size USB. That is in case you want to use your flash drives, things like that. This is the HP Tilt Pen. You can take a quick look at that as well. The interesting bit here is that this needs to be charged as well. It's not a battery, a removable battery, as we've seen before on some of the stylus that are on laptops. So to charge it, you twist the top and you push it back, and there you can see a USB Type-C port. So you can actually use the same supplied charger to charge it up. Lock it up. There's actually a button on the back, one here as well. Feels pretty lightweight, but high quality materials. So let's move on to the Spectre Folio now. Moving on to the Folio itself, it comes in a felt sleeve. This looks absolutely beautiful. So this is the Spectre Folio. You can see how thin that is when I hold it up on this side. The most special thing about the Folio is that it is the world's first leather convertible PC. So this is, it feels great. It is genuine leather. They call it cognac brown, the particular color that this is in. You can tell that the grain is pretty pronounced here. It's got beautiful stitching on all sides. And it's got a little bit of HP branding over here. It's not very visible, but it does say HP, the new HP logo here, and it says California, USA. And there is a little bit of a lip here that helps it, that helps raise the rest of the leather off the table when you put it, so it's not really flat. Let's open it up. So here's the design. The leather extends to the inside, to the palm rest as well. It almost looks like the laptop itself is a part of the leather. It's actually fused with the leather. So you can tell that the keys sort of merge into the leather like this. Beautiful design by HP. On the side here, you can see that there is a USB Type-C port. One of them here, and there's 3.5 mm. On the other side, we get two additional USB Type-Cs. You can see those now. Yeah, there you go. And individual chiclet style keys, a nice feeling. This is all metal. You can probably tell that there is the Bang & Olufsen logo right here. And we'll just get a little bit more into why this is called the Folio. It's a convertible, and the way it does that is quite interesting. So the screen, I can show you that from the side. So it can open and close just like a regular laptop, but the screen can also separate from the rest of the body, and you can put it in this mode, which they call forward. And in this mode, it sticks with magnets. You've got the screen facing you, the keyboard's completely hidden, but you still have access to the trackpad. And of course, this is the touchscreen as well. We'll power it on in the meantime so that we can talk a little bit more about it. I'm pressing the power button now. So this is a Core i7-8500Y processor. It's a 1.5 gigahertz. It's also a completely fanless design, in case you were wondering. So there are no vents or anything. There doesn't need to be any vents on the side or on the back, because it's a one piece leather around the back. It's a FHD 13.3 inch touch display, supposed to be a very efficient display, what HP tells us, in terms of power consumption. And it's also covered with Gorilla Glass 4 for scratch resistance. Other specs: this is 16 gigabytes of DDR3 RAM, a 512 gigabyte SSD drive. And the other thing about this is that it does have simultaneous pen and touch input. So the HP Tilt Pen that I showed you earlier, you can use that in the forward mode and use the touch input as well. If you pull the display up and you push it down, you enter tablet mode. So right now it's in tablet mode. Windows just asked me if I wanted to switch to tablet mode. You have that option. The other thing is that it has Windows Hello, the IR camera, a Windows Hello capable IR camera on the top over here. It's an 88 degree field of view. There are quad speakers, already mentioned that. Of the three USB Type-C ports, two of them are Thunderbolt. There's also Wi-Fi, AC, Bluetooth 4.2. And despite the really slim size and the weight, which is about 1.4 kilograms, it's got a pretty large 6L battery, and that should give you a full day and more of battery life. That is what HP is claiming. Do look out for our full review where we will be testing the battery life. The keyboard feels great. It's a metal area around the keyboard, no flex at all. You can probably see the backlit keyboard now, and there are two levels of backlighting, two brightness levels. Evenly lit backlighting there. And now coming to the important bit, the price of this super premium machine. Yes, this design, this beautiful design, is not going to come cheap. This is priced at 1,99,990, so just about 2 lakh rupees, but it is a fully specced out model, absolute top of the line, a little bit Spectre branding here that you probably can't see. And it does come with Windows 10 Pro, the Pro version, 64-bit. Of course, I did mention already, it's a touchscreen, so you can use it in tablet mode. And all of this is done with magnets, so you can tell how it operates quite easily. This is a free swivel. Prop that down, it sticks together with magnets. And lightweight design. Some of the complaints that that one normally has with convertibles is that when you swivel the screen around, you're actually touching the keyboard on the back. But no such problem with this, thanks to the unique design. So that's about it for the Spectre Folio. If you have any particular questions about this machine, any specifics, do let us know. There you can see that you can use it in the vertical portrait orientation as well. Switch it off to the side, switches back. Do reach out in the comment section if you have any questions. You can also reach out to me directly on Twitter, and I'll try and answer as many of the questions that I can. In the meantime, do look out for our full review. That will be posted online as well as in the print. Thanks for watching.